Welcome to the 2018 Korfball Varsity between on rivals Oxford and Cambridge, brought to you by CUKC BSS TV. Just what is Korfball? Well, we're about to find out. I'm Colin Knott, and as always, I'm joined by Alan George. Good afternoon, Alan.
Oh, God.
Indeed, Alan. After several years of domination in this fixture from Cambridge, would you say that they actually start today as underdogs due to the number and calibre of players that they've lost?
Oh, God, great.
Well, Oxford get us underway in their traditional navy strip, with Cambridge defending in their traditional light blue. Now, I've been informed by our obscure sports researcher, Holly Copter, that men and women play on the same team in Korfball, so do not adjust your sets if you're thinking there are some manly-looking women out there today, or indeed, vice versa. That is some defending from Cambridge. They've won the ball back via a restart for a defended shot. They now try to work it up the court to their cohorts in the attacking division. So we're employing a tight press here, putting them under a lot of pressure. Long ball it is, received by record signing George Crane. They work it around the post. Long ball over to the young academy player Emily Young. Takes the shot! Collected by Oxford's Czech international player. Some sort of foul there from Oxford. Long ball from Captain Mason at the restart, and Cambridge are on the attack again. Radford. Crane in the feed. Young thinks about the shot, but beats her marker into the feed, and oh, sublime skill there to play the overhead pass, fooling everyone in the process. Oxford in possession now, working it around the post. That's a fumble. And a superb interception from the Irish international, Sam Galvin, there.
Well, that's a great work from Galvin.
Shinahara in the feed, plays it out to the Captain Mason. She shoots. Oh! And Cambridge are off the mark in this game.
It's a good pass out to her, but then it's all about the captain. She cocks it, she pulls the trigger, and then it's straight on target from here.
A cracking goal to get Cambridge underway in this contest. Of course, that puts Oxford back on the attack. Well, this really isn't going well for Cambridge. 11-1 at the half. I imagine some pretty stern words were said at half time.
You'd think so, Guy. I was expecting a much more competitive score, I'll be honest.
I think we all were, Alan. It looks like it could be getting worse for them here. Sam Galvin has gone down injured and is hobbling about quite a bit.
He looks to be a sub to scope for.
Yes, indeed he does. And it appears the decision to substitute him has been made. Ben Stoddart-Stone's coming on in his stead. Well, in amidst all that drama, the referee appears to have ordered a penalty to Cambridge, which George Crane will take in Galvin's absence. And he finishes it with ease.
Well, absolutely right, Colin. Textbook penalty.
Stockdale with the inbound to Shinahara. Captain Bethany Mason on the ball now. Back into Shinahara. Takes a step. Shoots. And oh, that's a goal. That's 12-3.
Yes, well, it's a simple goal, Colin, but it takes an awful amount of skill. He takes a step, makes a space for the shot. It's a cracking goal.
Oxford now gets underway with a stuttering restart. The score remains 12-3 after that attack. Pass comes into Shinahara. He turns, he shoots, and he's scored again!
Well, the pass comes in from absolutely nowhere, which I'm sure confuses a few people. But from there, it's all about this man. He pivots, he shoots, and it's another superb finish from the Japanese import.
Oxford passing it around in attack. Number 10's being encouraged to shoot by his teammates. He doesn't fancy it. The captain will have a go instead. And that's long, that's collected by Hajime Shinahara. Ball's in and Cambridge are on the attack. Crane to Galvin. Another long ball back to Crane. He shoots from distance. Oh, what a finish.
Yes, well, they look like they're having a lot of fun playing together, these two. It's another great exchange. And then this shot, he leaves his marker swatting at nothing but flies up there.
Well, it's a free pass to Oxford here. Crane goes hard to block the shot, but it's missed anyway. Cambridge really starting to find their groove here in the second half. Ball's in and Cambridge on the attack again. Ball is passed out wide. They look to be assessing their options here. Back to Mason, into Shinohara. Mason receives it again. She shoots. Oh, and she's dropped it in from range.
It's another excellent piece of play from this promising partnership for Cambridge. Mesa here, she just nonchalantly tosses it up there.
That goal makes it 13-6. Is there a comeback on the cards?
I don't think so.
Galvin on the ball here for Cambridge. Passes to Crane. Slick pass into Lorna Radford at the post. Boys now trying to run at the feed, make some space. It's a rough pass, but retained possession by Cambridge. And that's a speculative effort from range from Crane. Again, retained possession by Galvin. Long ball over the top. Oxford have... Oh, but what's happened here? Crane has struck his opponent in the face. Oxford are not happy about this, but he's gone over to apologise. Let's have another look at that.
Well, I don't think there's any malice in it, but it does appear that he's made contact with his player. Let's slow it down even further, see what we can see. Yep, there's the telltale comic book graphic and the hint of a Wilhelm scream.
Oh, that goal from Oxford takes it to 16-6. It's Stockdale on the ball for Cambridge. To the captain, Bethany Mason. Back to Stockdale. Into Shinohara, who's really been one of the star men for this Cambridge team in the second half. Ball goes out wide. Oh, Shinohara's found some space. And the little magician just pops it in, easy as you like.
Well, as you say, he just comes alive in these sorts of situations. He loses his marker completely, and then it's a simple finish from there.
Well, he certainly does make it look simple at times, doesn't he? With the score at 16-7, time fading in the game, you really do get the sense that Cambridge are just playing for their pride here. Shinohara? I don't know what's just happened, but Shinohara scored. Wizard.
Well, it's another piece of magic. Even the ball seems surprised to be up there by the post. Takes a while to drop. Here's a sensational goal.
That's it. That's the final whistle. Oxford have regained the Varsity Trophy. Thank you for joining us here at CUKC BCS TV.